Hello you guys, and welcome back to my channel, Joy to the World. I'm Joy, also known as Sav, also known as Savvy, also known as Savannah, also known as Vanna. You already know the intro, you already know the vibes, and today's video is going to be all about my lock moisturizing routine. The reason why I chose to do this video is because I have a lot of black kings and queens who are ignorant to the idea of how to moisturize their locks. And so I feel like this video was most definitely overdue. If you have not noticed, my hair has grown profusely since I have actually started my lock journey, and I have found out what works for me and my hair type, which is 4C, by the way. And I just wanna share that with you all and for my other kings and queens who have locks as well. So we're gonna go ahead and just get right into it without any further delay. So basically what I try to explain to people is that oil by itself does not moisturize. Oil acts as a sealant. You have to add water or some other moisturizing property first before you add your sealant. So that being said, one thing that I found that works for my hair, some people use rose water, some people use just water. What I choose to use is good old aloe vera juice. Aloe vera has a plethora of beneficial properties for the skin as well as for the hair and scalp. What I normally do is I take a spray bottle and I fill it up to about here with aloe vera juice, and then I fill it up the rest of the way with water and I shake it up, spray it in my hair like so. And you don't want to get your hair saturated. I want to say you want to get your hair about 40 to 60% wet or damp. And then after you do that, you're gonna wanna seal it with some type of oil of some sort. After I use my aloe vera spray, then I just grab my oil and I sit here and evenly distribute it through my parts. I start at the scalp, and then I just work it down the ends of my hair. If y'all have not noticed, I recently bleached some of my locks. So it is most definitely imperative for me to moisturize my hair on a daily basis. Just because I don't want my hair to break off. One thing that people make the mistake of using on their locks is leave-in conditioners, deep conditioners, which don't come for me in the comments, but it's okay, I guess. Everybody's hair is different, everybody's locks are different, but one thing that has been proven is that most conditioners, leave-in conditioners, deep conditioners, they leave buildup. And we all know what buildup equates. Buildup equates lint, you know, thick patches of crud in between and in your locks, and that's just, it's not cute. We don't want that. That's basically all I do to moisturize my locks. I literally use a mixture of aloe vera juice and water, mist my hair, and then I seal it. Remember, oil's a sealant. I seal it with my homemade lock potion, and that has been doing wonders for me and my locks. Another thing that you want to make sure that you do during your lock journey, you want to take vitamins. Vitamins? Why vitamins, might you ask? I'm gonna let you know. So basically, about 4 months ago, I went to my loctician to get a retwist, and I came to find out that I was losing hair badly. I'll insert a picture right here, but I was losing hair. My locks were thinning, and it was really It was depressing. It was so depressing. And I had no idea. I thought I was doing everything right. I thought my hair was healthy. And it was most definitely a reality check. So I ended up having to get a undercut to help conceal, you know, where I was losing hair. And I'll also insert a picture of that here. But as of right now, my undercut is growing back out. My loctician has a bag of my locks in her drawer somewhere that she is going to actually reattach for me once my hair gets long enough. I'll go ahead and show you all my undercut. So yeah, I lost about 2 rows of locks, and that was very, almost damn near traumatic for me. I've wanted locks for such a long time, and like I said, I thought I was doing everything right just to find out that I was losing hair. One reason I was losing hair was, one, because of stress. The number two reason I figured out that I was losing hair is because I am severely anemic. To the point where I've had to have blood transfusions in the past, but that's a whole nother video. But anyway, I was not taking my iron supplements the way that I was supposed to. So it was causing me to literally lose hair in 2 specific spots. So because of that, and I recently found out that iron deficiency causes hair loss, I have been making it a point to take hair, skin, and nail vitamins as well as iron supplements. And since I've been doing that, as you can see, my hair has been growing back slowly but surely, but it's been growing back. So I just wanted to throw that in there, that along with your moisture routine, whatever that may be, make sure that you are taking care of your body as well. Make sure that you're eating right, drinking water, taking vitamins, whatever nutrients that you may not have, or you know, might be deficient in. Make sure that you take vitamins to supplement that, because if you do not, your body's gonna tell you in more ways than one. So yeah, I just wanted to make sure I threw that in there, because like I said, I thought I was doing everything right and my locks weren't as healthy as they could have been because my body wasn't as healthy as it could have been. Another thing that I wanted to add, just to let y'all know, since this is a lock update video, I recently was afforded the chance to sit and actually count how many locks I have. I have a total right now of 90 little babies on my head, and I have recently hit my 1 year mark. I have officially been locked for 1 year. It was a year, April 19th. So it has actually been a year and a little bit over 2 months since I've started my lock journey. And I always tell people this, I really should have started my lock journey sooner. Having locks is literally the best thing that I could have done for my hair and really for my self-esteem as well. I do not regret it. It's something that I am so happy and so relieved that I did. And if you are thinking about locking your hair, this is your sign to do it. Do it. I promise you, you will not regret it. Do it, stick with it, be patient. I gotta say that again. Be patient, because it is a journey, and it is called a journey for a reason. But once you actually go through it and your hair starts to grow, you will really start to see the benefits of having locks and what it does for you spiritually, emotionally, and psychologically, like I said, because self-esteem, as my hair grows and as I get a retwist, my self-esteem gradually grows and increases as well. So if you've been thinking about getting locks, make sure that you do some research. Make sure that it's something that you really want to do. Don't do it just because it's a thing. Don't do it just because you saw somebody else do it. Do it because you know in your heart that you want to do it and you're going to stick with it. Because like I said, it is called a journey for a reason. Another thing that I wanted to add in my previous video where I spoke about my bedtime routine, I said that I sleep with a wave cap along with a bonnet. Obviously my hair is too long to be in a wave cap now. So I have ditched the wave cap entirely and all I use is my bonnet. So sometimes at night, if I didn't moisturize it during the day, I'll do my moisture routine and then I'll just throw my bonnet on and I'll go to sleep and just let all the juices and oils kind of seep into my hair and into my scalp. And granted, I have to wash my pillowcase all the time because it's always filled up with oil and shit. But anyway, your hair will most definitely feel softer. You will notice a difference. Just make sure that you make a point to moisturize your locks. I cannot stress that enough. Whatever you use to moisturize your locks, that is on you. But do not have locks and just don't think that you have to do nothing to them, because locks still take care. They still take maintenance. Even if you're doing freeform locks, they still require moisture. Anything that's living, anything that's alive requires moisture, requires water. Look at your hair as if it is a plant and take care of it. You can't just lock your hair and expect it to flourish and be healthy. That's just not how it works. But yeah, that's all I believe that I have for you guys. Make sure you tune in to my previous videos if you have not already. I will make a conscious effort to try to record and upload more since my life is kind of calming down for the moment. But I appreciate you so much for taking the time to watch this video. And if you are a previous subscriber, thank you for sticking with me. I know I haven't been the most consistent as far as my uploads, and I apologize for that most definitely. But if you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for your loyalty and your consistency and your love and support. Most definitely, it is appreciated more than you know. And I will most definitely be talking to you guys soon. And remember, moisturize your hair, wear your bonnet, and yeah. Peace, love, and hair grease.